Hey, I'm going to show you how I use text replacement or how I use Typinator. Typinator is a text replacement program. Basically, you type something and it's going to type something else for you. I'll just show you my favorite stuff and we'll go from there. First, I'll show you how it works. So you have your abbreviation sets, and these are all just things I made up. I'm going to go ahead and make one for the productivity shop. So I'll go ahead to my Luke abbreviations, actually start a new one, new abbreviation set, the productivity shop. I'll do a plus sign here to add a new abbreviation. I'll type the abbreviation that I want. So the first thing that comes to mind, and something that I'm not gonna commonly type. So I'll do maybe the productivity shop, TPS. That might come up in a word or an abbreviation. So I'll do P shop. Whenever I do P shop, the productivity shop will appear. Let's test it out. So P shop, boom, the productivity shop appears. Now, there's other programs that can do this. Alfred Snippets, A Text, which is $5, and I recommend Text Expander. I'll show you why particularly I like Typinator. So along with, well, this is probably with other programs too, but let's say I wanna do P shop and then today's date. You can do variables inside of the expansion. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to these three dots here, and then I'm gonna choose some of the available variables. And maybe I'll do year, and then comma, month, comma, the time zone. So now when I go to my test document, and I do pshop, it's going to add the variable content inside as well. Something really cool that I did for work recently, I have to go to a document with today's date, but then I also have a document with last week's date. So rather than figure out what the date was last week, I go ahead and do today's date minus 7, which is pretty cool. How it works is I have documents called RT0204, so that'll be today's documents, and then I'll want to go ahead and go 7 days back. So let's set it up how I have it on my work computer. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a new shortcut and call it RTD. So that's just what I use for work. And then I do RT and then the current month in two numbers. So month and then the current day in two numbers. So if it's a single number, there's gonna be a 0. Okay, RTD. And then it pulls up my shortcut. But then if I'm gonna go to last week's, I wanna do minus 7. So in Typinator, I'm gonna do another one. I'm gonna do RTL, so D is for day and L is for last week. It's just whatever comes to my mind. I'm gonna do the same thing, but then before, I'm gonna type bracket bracket day delta equals minus 7. And then when I go to my document, RTL, it's gonna do last week. Pretty cool. I'm just thinking, let's do something like 60 days ago. So I do DT for today's date in full form. So DT. Let's try to see what happens when we do DT plus 60. So we'll just use this one for now. I'm gonna go ahead and do find DT. And here it is. And I'll put it here. And then we'll do the bracket bracket day delta plus, let's do minus 60. Ooh, this will be super cool if it works. So RTL, and I'm not gonna guess if that's right, but I guess it looks pretty right. That's pretty cool. And then another thing that I use text replacement for is whenever I have to type complicated codes or terminal things or something where it's just like a line of code, but then I just need to change one thing, I use text replacement with input variables. I'll show you what that means. So whenever I'm Apple scripting, I use text replacement a lot to be faster. But anyway, usually I have to write tell application quote Google Chrome to activate. When I run this test script, Google Chrome will activate and come to the front. That's a lot of typing for me. So what I did was I created a text expansion shortcut where it'll insert a variable for Google Chrome. So what I did was I combined the first word tell and the first letter of the word application into tella. So whenever I type tella, it'll go ahead and do my text replacement shortcut. So I'll do tella, and then a window will pop up. and I have a little note saying, reminding me what's I need to type in. So I'll type in Google Chrome, and then boom, you can see that it wrote a hint, it put Google Chrome here, and it wrote all of the code that I usually write. So I'll try Finder, or I'll do another example, like tell Luke if Luke was an app, and you can see that it puts it in there. I'll show you how to set it up. So I'll go to Typinator, I'll type in my code, and you can see the code here. Let's go ahead and make our own from the beginning. So I'll go ahead and just type out exactly what I want. And then what you do is you do bracket bracket, question mark, and then a variable name. So this will just be what pops up in front of the dialog box. So I'll do which app, and then I'll do bracket bracket to close. And everywhere where I want the input variable to appear, I'll just paste this code. You don't have to remember this code. It's available in the little drop-down menu. So I'll go ahead and update mine to say which app. So now when I go to Adam and I do Tella, it'll say which app. You can see right here, and then I can type my app in order to find the input menu. We just go to the three dots and do input field, and then you can choose from the options here. I'll go ahead and do an example app. And then if you want a default value, you can do that. Usually I don't, because I like to keep it simple. And you can see that it just does bracket bracket question mark app. I prefer this over Text Expander. Text Expander is very powerful as well. However, the code to do this is a little bit more complicated. And yeah, just a personal preference. I got Typinator from a free pack, and I've just been sticking with it. Another thing that I use text replacement for is for bookmarks. A lot of the times I don't want to go to Chrome, go to my bookmarks, or search for a certain thing, and I just remember it in my head. So what I use it for is my Apple scripting key code website, not mine, key codes, and it'll go ahead and paste key codes for you. So yeah, just a medium long video on why I use Typinator and Text Expansion. If you have any questions, you can email me at hello@theproductivityshop.co, or you can join the Productivity Shop Slack channel. Thanks for watching. See you later.